Hey guys, welcome you all back to my YouTube channel Dharmik Reddy Tech World. Billions of people are using a lot of electronic devices. Therefore, it is natural that a lot of it arises. The World Health Organization is warning that the amount of e-waste around the world is growing significantly. Yes, our topic is e-waste. Now let's see, what is e-waste and why there are so many health risks associated with e-waste. E-waste is nothing but which describes discarded electronic devices. It is popular, informal name for electronic products nearing their end of their useful life. The danger produced from e-waste is from the harmful materials and direct contact of heavy metals such as chromium, cadmium and also lead. With inhalation of toxic fumes and also touching of toxic materials, and the main point is accumulation in soil, water and air, it can damage our kidney, our blood and also our peripheral nervous system. Now, types of e-waste. There are totally three types of e-waste. First one, large hold appliances e-waste. Second one, small house appliances e-waste. Third one, information technology. First one, large household appliances e-waste consist of refrigerator, freezer, dishwasher, washing machine, etc. Small household appliances consist of hairdryer, toaster, washing machine, iron, etc. And information technology and telecommunication equipment consist of private computers, telephones, mobile phones, printers, etc. When did this all begin? Electronic e-waste has been around for a very long time now. However, the proper disposal of electronic waste has started from the mid-17th century and was taken over by the United States and passed on the Resource Communication and Recovery Act. This law made it illegal to throw electronic waste in the United States. This is when the recycling industry was formed and the proper disposal of electronic waste started. Why is proper disposal of electronic waste is important to our environment? Old electronics, aka e-waste, consist of electronic equipment scrap, components like CPU, mobile phones, computers, laptops, etc. This e-waste contains potentially harmful materials like lead, cadmium, beryllium, bromide, flame retardants, and many more toxic elements that can poison and destroy our environment and the world we live in. In fact, the parts contained in e-waste truly can be considered if they are garbage or waste. But the toxic chemicals present in e-waste is also something we want to keep out of our environment and our landfills. As the amount of used electronics is being thrown out, it is increasing day by day. And also there's a very strong need to increase the recycling rate for e-waste. How much e-waste is actually being recycled? Shockingly, only 12.5% of e-waste is being recycled. Why? We have to give information to people to recycle their electronics instead of dumping them. It all begins from us. Is it illegal to dump your electronics? Here's why you should recycle them. If you're like a lot consumers, some people replace their electronics for few years. Others choose to toss their electronics in the drawer or in the closet. Some other people decide to throw away their electronics. Here are 7 ways to reduce your e-waste. Sell old electronics, donate old electronics, recycle and dispose your electronics properly, maintain your electronics, repurpose or revalue your electronics, and also buy Energy Star related electronics. Main point is learn to repair your broken electronics. Can e-waste be useful? Recycling of e-waste serves a lot of useful purpose, like protecting human and environment health by keeping those toxic materials out of our landfills. For example, you exchange your new TV set with the old one from the shop. Now you think that Once the shop sends the old TV set to the factory, they will recycle the old product. But unfortunately, that doesn't happen every time. Sometimes, instead of recycling the product, they burn down because they want to gain metals like gold, copper, etc. from these devices. Advantages of e-waste. Conserve natural resources. Recycling recovers valuable materials from old electronics that can be used to make new products. As a result, we have energy reduce pollution, reduce greenhouse gas emissions, and save natural resources by extracting fewer raw materials from the earth. Now, disadvantages of e-waste. As mentioned, electronic waste contains toxic components that are dangerous to human health, such as mercury, lead, cadmium, barium, and lithium. The negative health effects of these toxins on human include brain, heart, liver, kidney, and skeletal system damage. Now, the conclusion of this video. E-waste recycling is necessary, but it should be conducted in a safe and standardized manner. The acceptable risk for hazards. Secondary, e-waste substances should not be different for developing or developed countries. Thank you friends for watching this video on the topic e-waste. Subscribe my channel for my upcoming videos. I see you guys in the next video.